This is one of the chapters in navigation safety topic, marine communications. The International Code of Signal, ICS, is an international system of signals and codes for use by vessel to communicate important messages regarding safety of navigation and related matters. The International Code is the most recent evolution of a wide variety of maritime flag signaling system. The purpose of the International Code of Signal is to provide ways and means of communications in situations related essentially to safety of navigation and persons, especially when language difficulties arise. One of the elegant aspects of the ICS is that all of the standardized messages come in 9 languages, as of English, French, Italian, German, Japanese, Spanish, Norwegian, Russian, and Greek. Every single flag represents an alphabetic letters and certain meanings. These are the flag's meanings. A alpha means I have a diver down, keep well clear at slow speed. B bravo, I'm taking in or discharging or carrying dangerous goods. This is originally used by the Royal Navy specifically for military explosive. C Charlie, affirmative. D Delta, keep clear of me, I am maneuvering with difficulties. E Echo, I am altering my course to starboard. F Foxtrot, I am disabled, communicate with me. G Golf, I require a pilot. If by fishing vessel near fishing ground, it means I am hauling nets. H Hotel, I have a pilot on board. I India, I am altering my course to port. J Juliet, I am on fire and have dangerous cargo on board, keep well clear of me. Or I am leaking dangerous cargo. K Kilo, I wish to communicate with you. L Lima, in harbor it will be the ship is quarantined. While at sea, it means you should stop your vessel instantly. M Mike, my vessel is stopped and making no way through the water. N November, negative. O Oscar, man overboard. It is often attached to the man overboard pole on boats. P Papa or the Blue Peter, in harbor, all persons should report on board as the vessel is about to proceed to sea. And it may be used by fishing vessel to mean my net have come fast upon an obstruction. Q Quebec, my vessel is healthy and I request free pratique. R Romeo, for this flag there is no ICS meaning as a single flag. S Sierra, I am operating stern propulsions. T Tango, keep clear of me, I am engaged in pair trawling. U Uniform, you are running into danger. V Victor, I require assistance. W Whiskey, I require medical assistance. X X-ray, stop carrying out your intention and watch for my signal. Y Yankee, I'm dragging my anchor. And finally Z Zulu, I require a tug. Or by fishing vessel near fishing ground, it would mean I'm shooting nets. Besides flag signal as language of communications, Morse code is also a type of signal commonly used to convey messages. Morse code is a method of transmitting text information as a series of on and off tones, like or clicks, that can be directly understood by a skilled listener or observer without special equipment. It is named after Samuel F.B. Morse, an inventor of the telegraph machine. Morse code is transmitted using just two states, on and off. Historians have called it as the first digital code. Morse code may be represented as a binary code, as the short mark commonly by dot, or sound as dit, or any short pulse, while the longer mark will be a dash or da, or any longer beeping. Alphabets have variety of 1 to 4 series, while numbers will have 5 series of 10 variables from 1 to 0. The gap between character will be short, and just short gap between letters, while a minimum gap of interval will be applied between the words. Another type of communications is the Global Maritime Distress and Safety System, GMDSS. It is an internationally agreed upon set of safety procedure, type of equipment, and communication protocols used to increase safety and make it easier to rescue distressed ship, boat, and aircraft. The system is intended to perform the function of alerting, including position determination of the unit in distress, searching and rescue coordination, locating, which is homing, maritime safety information broadcasting, general communications, and bridge-to-bridge communications. The fundamental difference between the old and the new distress system is that the new system is shore-centered or shore-coordinated and move emphasis from ship-to-ship alerting to ship-to-shore alerting. The new system is quicker, simpler, and most importantly, more efficient and reliable from the old manual Morse code and radio telephone alerting system. GMDSS is specifically designed to automate a ship's radio distress alerting function and consequently remove the requirement for manual or human watchkeeping on distress channel. The basic concept of the system is that search and rescue authorities ashore as well as shipping in the immediate vicinity of the ship in distress. It will be rapidly and automatically alerted to a distress situation so that they can assist in a co-coordinated SAR operation with minimum delay. The system also provides for urgency and safety communications and the promulgations of maritime safety information, the MSI, including navigational, meteorological warnings and forecasts and other urgent safety information to the ships. In other words, every ship fitted with appropriately of GMDSS is able, irrespective of the area in which it operates, to perform those communication functions which are essential for the safety of the ship itself and safety of the other ship operating in the same area. The communication functions was mentioned in the Safety of Life at Sea, SOLAS Convention, which this chapter will cover only 9 of it. The GMDSS, as described in SOLAS Chapter 4, defines that the first functional requirement as distress alerting over ship to shore, which every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting ship-to-shore distress alerts by at least 2 independent means, each using a different radio communication service. The 3 basic means of transmitting a distress alerts are by emergency position indicating radio beacon or EPIRB, digital selective calling, DSC, or International Maritime Satellite Organization or Inmarsat. Secondly, distress alerting shore to ship, which states every ship while at sea shall be capable of receiving shore-to-ship distress alerts. This function may be fulfilled by either 2 means: direct broadcast to vessel from Shore-Based Rescue Coordination Center (RCC) using DSC by the medium frequency, high frequency or very high frequency bands, or using broadcast of Maritime Safety Information (MSI) by using either NAVTEC service or the Safety Net service. The third is distress alerting ship to ship, that every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting and receiving ship to ship distress alert. Transmission of ship to ship distress alerts can only be accomplished by 2 methods. First, by VHF channel 16, the distress safety and calling channel, or VHF channel 13, the bridge to bridge communication channel. Or then by using digital selective calling (DSC) by either MF, HF or VHF. Next is the search and rescue coordinating communications, where every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting and receiving search and rescue coordinating communications. The purpose of this requirement is to coordinate search and rescue communication between all vessel and aircraft that may be involved in the incident. Voice communication would normally be used, although initially promulgation of information through the broadcast of maritime safety information may be used by a rescue coordination center to ascertain which vessel are in the area of the incident and are in a position to assist. Thus, any of the following methods of communication could be used, like transmission reception of maritime safety information, NAVTEC or safety nets, voice communication using MF or HF or VHF, or either Inmarsat. On-scene communication suggested that every ship while at sea should be capable of transmitting and receiving on-scene communication. The purpose of this requirement is to coordinate search and rescue and other communication between all vessels and aircraft that may be involved at the scene of the incident. Voice communication using MF, HF or VHF would normally be used. The sixth is locating. That every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting and as required by regulation for receiving signal for locating. This can be achieved by using radar for receiving and SART, search and rescue radar transponder for transmitting. In the transmission and reception of maritime safety information, every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting and receiving maritime safety information. For example, by using NAVTEC, reception by terrestrial communication, and safety net to transmit and receive by satellite communication. Next, the general radio communications, where every ship while at sea shall be capable of transmitting and receiving general radio communications to and from shore-based radio system or network, subject to Regulation 15.8. The general communication may be carried out utilizing the following system. It is digital safety calling to set up a telephone, telex link on MF, HF or VHF in Marsat network. And finally, the bridge-to-bridge communication. For every ship while at sea, shall be capable of transmitting and receiving bridge-to-bridge communication. Ship would normally use VHF communication to carry out this function. The normal use of this function would be for port operation and pilotage. Occasionally, for longer range, MF and HF or Inmarsat could be used. The setting up of communication using MF, HF would be via digital set of calling. Alright, that's all for this chapter. Thank you.